Hi, I'm Sarah, a healthcare professional, and today I will be helping a patient like you learn how to prepare and use the Respimat inhaler. In order to feel confident that it's helping deliver the medicine your doctor prescribed, it's important to familiarize yourself with the Respimat inhaler and how to use it properly. The Respimat inhaler delivers a soft mist that eases the effort to inhale your medicine. This instructional video has been created to help you get the most from your treatment through proper inhaler use. Each month when you refill your prescription and receive your new Respimat inhaler, you can watch this video to ensure you're doing the steps correctly and get the full benefit of your treatment. Today I'll be working with Henry, a patient like you. This is his first time using the Respimat inhaler. We will be going through the steps of using the Respimat inhaler together so he can become familiar and feel comfortable using it as part of his treatment plan. I tell Henry that I'm going to help him assemble and prime his inhaler. This will be presented in four sections. Label your discard by date, load your medication, prepare your inhaler, and spray four mists. Then I'm going to educate Henry on using his inhaler every day using the top method. Henry looks intimidated, but I assure him that he has nothing to worry about. Like anything new, once you become familiar with the process, you will feel more comfortable and be able to do the steps on your own. I remind him he can always refer to this instructional video as a refresher to ensure he is preparing and using his Respimat inhaler correctly. First, let's take a look at the components of the Respimat inhaler. Depending on what your doctor prescribed, your inhaler cap may be a different color. Before we go into detail about how to use the Respimat inhaler, it's important for Henry and you to become familiar with the Respimat inhaler components or parts. There are two main components: the inhaler, which consists of the cap, mouthpiece, air vent, dose release button, safety catch button, and the clear base with the piercing element, and then the cartridge that holds the medication that fits inside. The safety catch button along the side allows the clear base to separate from the top of the inhaler. Pushing up on the cap's opening tab reveals the mouthpiece. Along the sides of the mouthpiece are two air vents. Be sure not to cover these when using the inhaler. The medicine is discharged as a soft mist from the medication cartridge when the dose release button is pressed. A dose indicator on the side of the inhaler shows about how many doses are left. When the indicator points to the red area, it's time to prepare your next inhaler. How do you assemble the Respimat inhaler? We'll cover that next. I give Henry a Respimat inhaler, and together we go through the steps to assemble it. First, press the gray safety catch button. Then, with the other hand, pull down on the clear base. This lets the two pieces come apart. I point out the piercing element and remind Henry to be careful not to touch it. Next, we write the discard by date on the label. Once the medicine is put into the inhaler, it is good for 3 months. So the discard date is 3 months from today's date. To load his medication, Henry inserts the narrow end of the cartridge into the inhaler. Placing the inhaler on a flat surface like a table or counter, Henry pushes down firmly until he hears a click. He then replaces the clear base by aligning the notch with the safety catch button and slides them together until they click. Now the inhaler is ready for priming. Before it can be used for the first time, the assembled inhaler needs to be primed. I show Henry how to prepare his Respimat inhaler. With the cap closed, I turn the clear base half a turn and hear a click. Next, we push up on the circular opening tab until the cap snaps fully open. With the inhaler pointed toward the ground, we press the dose release button. We then repeat turn, open, press with the inhaler pointed toward the ground until there are four mists released from the inhaler. Between each spray, I remind Henry to close the cap and turn the base until he hears a click. The arrows on the label are there as a reminder of the direction the base turns. Henry's inhaler is now ready for daily use. Feel free to watch this section again and go through the steps one more time if you have any questions. Otherwise, you're ready to move on to using your Respimat inhaler daily. To use his Respimat inhaler daily, Henry uses the word top to remember the steps. That stands for turn, open, and press. For turn, With the cap closed, Henry turns the clear base in the direction of the arrows, half a turn, until he hears a click. For open, he pushes on the small circular tab until the cap snaps fully open. Press is how he takes the medication. He starts by breathing in and then out slowly and fully to empty his lungs. Placing his lips around the mouthpiece, being careful not to cover the air vents, he points the inhaler at the back of his throat. While taking a slow, deep breath through his mouth, Henry presses the dose release button. After inhaling his medication, Henry holds his breath for 10 seconds, or for as long as comfortable for him. Depending on what medication your doctor has prescribed, you may need to repeat this. Remember to use your medication as directed by your doctor. When the dose indicator on the side moves into the red area, it's time for Henry to prepare his next inhaler using the same steps I showed him in the office. Henry is no longer apprehensive about using his new Respimat inhaler. Now that Henry is home, he might have questions. If so, he can consult the instructions for use inside the medication box, speak to his doctor or pharmacist, or call 1-800-542-6257. He can also go to respimatquickstart.com for more help. The Respimat inhaler. For daily use, remember TOP for turn, open, and press.